All right, so that was funny. I just accidentally ran the game in full screen mode and started debugging it and crashed the whole computer. I mean, well, not really crashed it, but I couldn't press any keys. I was totally stuck. So I had to restart my computer. We're back though. We're back to the stream. Yeah, I couldn't get anything. Yeah, there's nothing I could do. I tried Command Option Escape to bring up the force quit menu and then try and like hit some keys on the keyboard that might luckily close Xcode, but there was just no way to get that lucky. So I tried everything. I tried the command quit and all that. Okay, so now we're debugging in full mode instead of full screen, borderless mode. What's up, Thomas? Okay, so I'm trying to get this window string to work, and I think something's wrong with... Yeah, oh, see, it got the vowel full. What is it when it gets this string here, get localized string? What string is it actually getting? Key. Menu settings window dash blank. That's the problem. Vowel.cster. I just checked vowel. It was good. Oh. Does anyone see the error? Ba-bam! Duh. Derp, derp, derp. Okay, so now it should have, and now it should show me the window size setting. And hopefully we can just cycle through them all, and then I'll add a little notice saying, hey, you gotta restart the game if you want to apply this. Yeah, borderless, sweet. Window 1080p, 768p, 840p. 840p should be like second or whatever. Let's go to window 840p. Exit the game, see how if that worked. Should have. Set it. Boom! You gotta restart too? Yes, look at this! We got windowed mode! We can change it. Let's go all the way down to 240. Game Boy. Should I call it Game Boy? That'd be kind of fun, right? Or keep it as windowed 240p, which isn't really a thing, is it? So we got movie medium, iPad small, tiny. I'm gonna call it Game Boy and see how that looks. Game Boy, we'll call this one iPad. Yes, Game Boy, nice. Oh, that's right. Game Lad. Yeah, I agree, right? That might be a bad thing. Game Girl? Game Girl! Boyish Game? Game Jib? Game Jib, kind of cool. Game Girl's kind of good. Game Lad. Game Child? Game Child. Vote Game Jib? Game Foo? Gameling? Man Game. Now it doesn't even make sense. Game Girl? What are some other like synonyms for boy? I'm trying to think of some, but I'm drawing a blank. Lad, schoolboy, youth, game youth, game laddie. Game guy. Game guy. Game buck. Game dude. Yeah. Game laddie is pretty good. Game cog. I kind of like game guy and game dude. Game Sprout. Game Whippersnapper. Yeah, right, Playboy. Game Dude Junior. Game Dude Junior. Let's see how they look. Let's try Game Guy, Game Girl, all of them. Game Whippersnapper? Whippersnapper. You know that word actually comes from whip snapper? It's kind of hard to see, but that's Game Guy. Let's go back into full. Game Kid. Oh, but it's already in Isaac? Oh. Tiny when it is tiny, right? That's the Game Boy. But it's especially tiny because on my laptop, but it's, you know, I think it's because I'm Retina. Game Guy. Game Guy's funny. Game Girl. Game Girl. Game Laddie. Game Guy's pretty cool, right? It's kind of the same thing. Game Laddie. I don't know if it makes as much intuitive sense. Game, what was the other good ones? Game Bro. Game Bro is pretty good. It's really close to Game Boy. Game Bro. Whoops. Game Bro. I kind of like Game Bro. Yes. Game Bro and Game Guy. Both of those are really good. But I think Game Bro is even better because it's the same number of letters as boy and it's got a B in it. So it's like even more intuitive. Yeah, you vote Bro? Cool. Yeah, he's definitely on the bro side. Alright, Game Bro it is. You vote Pizza. You always vote Pizza. I just thought of something really important, actually, that the game needs to do. When it starts, and it sets the default setting for window size, it needs to, if it's debug mode, so yeah, in debug mode, it definitely needs to never ever set me to automatically set me to full screen mode. So only in release mode. Actually, let's make this more debuggable. String val k default window size if not defined in debug val equals full. Boom. Right now it's more debuggable. Val. Game test string setting val. So there, I'm gonna set a breakpoint there before it even does this. Let's set the window size completely, take it away. And this should be safe now so that it doesn't crash the stream again. If it does crash the stream again, I'm sorry. Please don't crash the stream. Bro is most fitting. Is the windowed mode with a border? Or is it border? Yeah, the windowed mode is always bordered. You should make the option where it randomly picks six letters for a seed. Ooh. Random seed option. That's cool. Random seed option. Let's add that to the Trello right now. Random seed. This will be a design thing. Easy to implement. Okay, so there. We got this breakpoint. It's going to set the string to full. Good. There. What's up, Lakebird? Less random seed that always sends it to Gary. But make sure it doesn't pick secret seeds. Oh, yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah. Cool. All right, yeah, so I think the window, oh yeah, the last thing to do is to add inside when it sets the windowed mode, it's gonna need to tell the player how to see their changes basically. Yeah, it's so nice having Trello. Gosh, it's really great to be able to communicate all these ideas and to you guys, but also with you guys, but with like it's also nice to like have it all visual, right? Like all these things I can kind of visually see what I need to work on rather than having this whole block of text list that I used to have, which was impossible to like see distinctly at a glance, you know, like what needs to be done. This is like something I can see at a glance, like, oh, here's some red items, these are really important. Here's some green items, these are like either fun or easy or like I can do right now, you know. I've set an official release date for Songbringer. No. Are you just turning away and adding content? Yes, I am. There's a beta version though coming up February 21st, Lakebird. So beta is then all the people that backed already at the beta level are going to get the game February 21st, and also people that are pre-ordering. So if you want to play it and you want to play the beta, you can pre-order at songbringer.com/pre-order, and that gets you permanent access to the game at the beta time. So you'll get the final version too, and you also get your name in the credits as a backer, like an honorary backer. Yeah, it has not been released yet. No, this is the alpha version. Yeah, this is definitely the alpha version. The release date is when the game is actually done after beta. This will be months down the road. There'll be an actual final release. There'll still be more like updates after that, but like that will be the actual final version, you know? It should pick from those. How much is left to do for me? Tons. Oh my God, there's so much left to do. This list here on Trello doesn't even include all the dungeons, enemies, items, secrets, and everything else that needs to get done before the game is considered complete and ready for a final release. There's a lot left to do in this game. There's a lot of content to be added, as well as code to be written and art to be created and stuff, you know. So we're gonna apply the notice. So, if we have choice.menu item, we're going to add to the menu item. Label dynamic cast. It's going to be label pointer based on choice.menu item get child by tag. Int tag, one, if label is not equal to null pointer, and we're going to create it. So label equals label create. No. It's what's it called? Oh, kit label. Should this thing glitch? Nah. This is the true story so far. Sweet, man. You gotta email this to me so I can check it out later. Oh, Happy Moose. You like Valtry? GCC hates it though? Why is that? You want Valtry pull requests for GCC error warning fixes? Yes. Happy Moose, please. Yes. Definitely send over some Valtry pull requests. I would love that, man. That's great. Full release party planned? Yeah, there'll be some kind of party when the game is fully done and finally released. Yeah. It'll be here in the San Francisco Bay Area. You know? Yeah. So this thing's parent is menu item. Its font file is cave font small. Its string is going to be game get localized string for menu window settings notice. Is that right? Menu settings window notice. Yep. And the pause, I'm not exactly sure what this position is supposed to be. Well, I'll guess. Wait. We just go vec2. I'm guessing. Guessing like 24 by like -6 times kit pixel. It's anchor point. Like anchor to the left, halfway on the Y. The Z is like 1. And set its tag so we can loot. Find it later. Might as well make this a const int tag 1. There. Okay, let's see if we got a notice now. So when we change the window size setting, it should like let us know. We're all invited for dinner. You're all invited. Invite your friends. It's just a Sterling that needs to include string.h. Oh. Signed, unsigned, though? Yeah. Well, I guess I could fix those. If there's any that you want to submit to, feel free to submit it. You could do like a different pull request if you got any, if it's like really bugging you and you want to fix it. I'll definitely check that stuff in, you know? Can I buy you an airplane ticket? Ticket, 28,000. What's the boss kind of thing called at the start of the game after you get the sword? Oh yeah, the Raz, the R-A-Z. Hey, see you later, thief. See you, man. Oh, sweet. Thanks, Happy Moose. Cool. Alright, so windowed. It definitely did not add an option for this. Hell, it probably shouldn't even have the option to be full screen in debug mode. It's easy to change. If def and debug. And debuff. And debug. And if. Nah, it looks kind of weird. All right. Yeah, all right, good. So I'm in debug mode and it will not let me do full screen. That's great. I won't ever make that mistake again. Okay, bro. Okay, so why didn't it show me that extra notice thing? She could be getting there. Oh no, this is equals null pointer. I'm making lots of derp mistakes today. But this one's almost done. This setting for windowed mode. It's cool. This will be a really nice thing to push into the update. I'll be updating probably to Steam tonight or tomorrow, maybe. But I kind of would like to get in the habit of maybe updating to Steam like once a week, like on Fridays or Saturdays. Might be like the good day to do it. Alright, great. Now I need to just get it to be less high. And yeah, I think an asterisk would be nice. And make it the same color as the window text. There's already a color for this, the menu something color string K font color. And it shouldn't have been so high up. I don't know why that was so. Oh, probably because it's from the bottom. And it should have an asterisk. And it should also have an asterisk after. So let's call this bool new is new. This is false. This is true. It's hardcore players only on Game Bro. What is the font you use for the text? It's all handcrafted font, man. I draw it all by pixel. You know, it's pixel art. It's in. I'll show you the file in a sec. That's working. Why didn't it? Yeah, here's here's one of the fonts. Right, so I draw it all like that. Yes, Bapu! Yeah, BDF Sam. It'd be so cool if he like randomly slipped in the seeds that we've been using, like poopy and stuff. Oh. Can't do an asterisk with the small little font. What can I do? A plus. It's kind of the same thing. Applies next time the game is started. I don't know if it needs that text after. Okay, so it should be higher up, like four more there. I'm not sure if it even needs this anymore. Is anyone close? That's cool, you pizza. Yes, that's all. That's good. It just says applies next time the game is started. I think it should go up maybe two more pixels. Let's see the game running that also at full screen at first. Borderless, I mean. You're rich, Buffo! A leaderboard? Whoa! That's so cool, dude! Mafu's getting dope! He's really fun! Oh, yeah, he can go up a couple more pixels. Let's do two more. Oh. Let's make that cleaner. What's up, GZ? You gonna make a game in JavaScript? Good luck, man. Good luck. What? So I need the, what about the font file? What you need? Artworld? What are you talking about the font file? Well, that's next time the game is started. Yeah, that's nice and tight, getting nice, like, close to its parent or whatever. Whoa, Thomas! Thomas, you got gifted! Dude, gifting, it's so cool! It's totally Burning Man. Yeah, almost the number of the beast. Oh, you want to number your streams? Oh yeah, totally. It's you already have the file. The file is right on your computer already. I'll show you where to find it. So when you go into your settings, or I mean into your game files, let's do it from Steam. I'll show you what I'm talking about. So yeah, you go into your local game files, and then it'll be one of the ping files in there. Yeah, so go Songbringer, properties, local files, browse local files. Go into assets, all right? You got this? Assets, textures. Right in here, there's a font called any one of them you want. There's small font. You can't see it because it's all white, but open this up in like Photoshop or whatever and you'll have the file. There's also font is the regular font size. You can see, oh, that one has some shadows, so you can kind of see what it is. And then there's also alien font, if you want to use those too, which do have numbers and everything too. So there you go. You got that, Hardboiled? Yeah, Scottish pizza, that's kind of one hard to implement, I would think, giving a point away all the time. Yeah, you got it right on. Cool. I think this feature is now done with the window size. This is pretty cool. I love this. Ready to check this in and work on the next thing, which is going to be, I'm going to make it so when you use the scanner drones and the map drones, they can be used in any level. So if you find your map drones or whatever in level 1, you can go use them on the overworld, level 3, whatever. Yeah! Let's see it run in iPad mode. Oh, that should still say... Oh yeah, let's do one more thing. So... let's make this a static bool. Is new. Or first time. Equals true. And then once we've done this, we'll go first time equals false. And this is first time. This would be first time if we used it. This we don't need anymore. And this we don't need anymore. Yeah. Yeah, so here's iPad mode. This is like really tall window. It might be interesting to play the game in this mode. Windowed 420, Game Bro, we've already seen. Windowed 1080, 840, iPad 420, Game Bro. Oh, it didn't change. Oh, it didn't change. Oh, if not first time. Oh, Thomas. Oh, so close, man. I'm sure it was close. I'm sure the random number was like 24% or something. Here we go. Okay, so we got windowed 840p. We'll go back into the settings. Oh, damn it. It still says windowed 840p. Oh, probably because this static bool is inside a lambda function. It's rigged. I know, Scottish pizza, all that effort. There we go. Okay, we got this. The notice. Damn, it still didn't work. Why not? First time should be. This is confusing me. Let's see what's actually happening. Every time we call the set window string method. Boogie, see you, man. Later. Boogie gave Boogie 2,000 points. Do. First time? What was it? I just went through all of it without even looking. Okay, this break showing point should be there. Okay, what's first time? This or static? This is a static. Can't see them all. What? I can't see this. Okay, so first time must have been true. Great. Great. Okay, why is it? Oh, because it hasn't created the choice menu item yet. I think there's some kind of every choice has a function that it can call. Menu item create callback. There it is. Takes a choice. So C dot menu item. Come on. Menu item create callback. Equals a new lambda function that takes a choice. And calls set window string. Based on the choice. Now we don't need this. So this will automatically get called when we create the win create it. And then it'll also have its menu item already created. Give him 1 point. Keep giving him 1 point. Nice exploit. No, you're exploiting. Menu item create callback. Wait, can we just go set music string? Oh. Do this for all these in case any of these also need to note something at some point. There. Well, as usual, one little thing always takes a little bit longer than I think, but hey, this is done. Nice, man. Right on. Yes. Yes. Oh, yes. That's awesome. Actually, I want it to be borderless, though. Dude, we got a window mode setting. About freaking time. Oh, it needs to play the sound. We go. This build will change everything. It's gonna be sweet though, definitely to have the map and the compass. That's what I'm gonna work on next. Right now, the map and the compass. Right, so is it booping? This is good enough to check in now, and actually really good set up well for the future if I want to add future options to this. But it's looking really good. I like it like that. Kind of don't even want to add any more options because it already looks really nice like that. Okay, so now I need to apply the bits of code that have changed to the master branch. What have I changed? I changed a bunch of other stuff this morning, but I think what I need to change, or all I need to check in, is game and title scene for this particular commit. I've got to get better with my Git, because goddamn, last night I spent 4 hours fixing my Git repo. Oh, it was hell. I was in Git hell last night. A lesson learned, never rebase if you've already pushed. Never rebase if you've already pushed, trust me. Don't even be tempted to try rebasing if you don't understand what it means to rebase. Yep, game is just, we took iPad, it loads the full screen default. Just game.cpp, yep. This is totally ready for this commit. Game scene, no, that's not, we don't need that. Hold on. Check this stuff. Oh, strings. Strings also is part of this commit. Common. No, common's not. Strings is for sure. Flux, definitely not. Game for sure. Title scene. Here we go. Yep, title scene. Cool. That's it. All right. So this is the window mode setting. Done. Push. How would the compass work? Okay, so the compass is going to work like this. If you already have defeated a boss, it will mark the compass as already completed. So if you've like, it won't show on, it'll show on your map a little bit different. If you have not used the compass, the boss will never appear on your map. If you have used the compass and you have not defeated the boss, it will be a red dot on your map. And you can use any compass in any dungeon or the overworld. You can also use any map in any dungeon or the overworld if you have unexplored positions. So if you've already explored every single area in a dungeon or the overworld, you will not be able to use your map anymore, or you won't be able to waste a map, basically. And same thing with the compass. You will not be able to use your compass if you've already identified the position of the boss or defeated the boss in that area. So I hope that makes sense how that's going to work. So let's skip menu and put the player wherever for. Pedro, what's this junior Dropbox content? It's a gray picture. Hey, what's up, Panda Lady? The browser could not allocate enough memory for the WebGL content. No, it's not replacing the scanner drones. So the scanner drones are the map. Sorry, I always say map and compass, but scanner drones are the map. The bio drones, the bio detector is the compass. So when I use those words, that's what I mean. So, all right, so I've got some of this code already written. So these are actually, I have 4 bio detectors from different dungeons, and I have 3 maps or scanner drones from different dungeons also. And I could use either one of these right here. Let's use a few. Yeah, so that should work. I'm gonna let it scan some stuff, and then I'll try and use it again, and it should not let me because I should have already filled in the whole dungeon. Let's use the biodetector too. See, that didn't work. Oh, it did work. Okay, there it is. Pattern this dungeon came up with. Okay, so see that? Now that it's explored every area, it won't let me equip this. Awesome. Okay, I'm gonna save my game here. And now when I go back and I try, if I were to manually equip one of the items, like let's say I tried to hack my save game and I want to equip map 6 because I still have those to be used. So let's manually equip map 6. And this should not work. It should still give me the ant noise if I have, if I try and use an item that I can't use. Yeah, yeah. Because I've already explored this whole dungeon. Everything is all blue or pink. But now I gotta get the body detector to work better. Risk of rain. I spot that. Nice. Got a Windows build that fast? Okay, so this is gonna solve two problems at once. I'm gonna create a new save game piece of data. This is gonna be called bosses, and it's gonna look like this. It's gonna be 0000000000 to start with. Let's say if I get the compass and or the biodetector. If I get the biodetector for one of the dungeons and I use it, it will give me a 2. Or yeah, that will mean that the boss has been discovered, like it's located, but I haven't defeated it. Once I defeat the boss, it will turn to a 1. So the 1 will mean, all right, I either defeated the boss or, yeah, I basically just, you defeated the boss. So 1 is you boss defeated, 2 is boss is located, 0 means neither. Deadbolt. Cool. Nice. Whoa. This is a really good trailer. I like the way they're building up the music and everything. Cool. I gotta check that out later. Okay, so now I gotta make this all happen. So in game.cpp again, we need this new setting. And the first thing I want to do is get rid of it when we erase the settings, because that's always something I always forget to do. And it's so important because that will cause your save game to get all messed up. Here it is, erase save game. So I'm going to add this doors, bosses. All right, now when it's there's gonna be two methods added to the world, and I guess the world's probably gonna keep the data for this. Yeah, world will keep the data. So this is gonna be a vector of integers. Not a map of integers, yeah. It's gonna be a map. No. I want this to be vector. Only Z0 through 9 can have these maps. Or compasses or whatever, bosses, yeah. So it's gonna be, yeah, a vector of ints, bosses. I'm gonna add a constant. Let's make this pretty, you know, easy for later. Enum kit boss status. Okay, boss unknown. Okay, boss defeated. Okay, boss located. So static boss type get or boss status get boss status in Z. And then also we need a couple methods to save all the boss status. Get doors. Get bosses basically. And static void set bosses const string. So yeah, we've got a get boss status function for methods to call. The save game will call get bosses and set bosses. This is gonna solve two problems at once. Yeah. It shall be mine. Oh, pizza. Relink the last video? Can I do that? Copy it. I'm on an iPad. I'm trying to copy it. It won't let me copy. You suck. Oh, my iPad Twitch viewer sucks. It doesn't let me copy links. Boo. Okay, next up in the world, let's get this looking good. When it clears the world, this is the most important thing. This clear. Come on, where's the clear method? There. This goes bosses.clear. Okay, next up, this can like set the bosses, get the bosses, see if a boss has already been gotten. All right. Boss status. Get boss status. Oh, we're also gonna need to set boss status. Yeah, let's add that right now. Duh. Set boss status. Give it a Z. And a boss status. Try to build your game. You got it, man. Yeah, I know, right? All right, if world.bosses.size, if Z is less than that, Or if z is less than 0, or z is greater than or equal to worlds.bosses.size. Return, what was that? Return k boss unknown. Otherwise, return world.bosses z. Great. Void world set boss status. All right, so we got to fill up the whole, we're going to make sure that the vector size is right. Int I equals 0. I is less than or equal to k world num levels. If world.bosses. Oh, dude, we should do this when we set up bosses. Bosses.clear. What's that command to repeat a bunch of things into a vector? Insert. Oh yeah, you can just insert the same value like a million times. Bosses.clear, bosses.insert. Of course, my autocomplete doesn't work though. All right, Thomas, see you, man. See the font.font does not appear a valid font. No, no, it's a ping. Look at the ping file, man. The ping file, not the font file. The font file is this data that you're not going to be able to read. The ping file is the image. So just load your ping file in something like, you know, some kind of video editor. Like a image editor, and then take the letters you want. Insert, come on, insert, come back, autocomplete. Just look it up. Vector insert, C++11. All right, the one I'm thinking of, yeah, position, value type, n, that's it. Position, n, value type. Vector, bosses.insert, bosses.begin, the number, k, world, num, levels, plus one, value zero, or k, boss, n, noun. There, so we start the world, we always have a clear boss array with enough bosses. Man, it is compiling so slow. Indexing like crazy slow today. What's up? My laptop's been acting weird this morning. Xcode's using a lot of memory already too. 2 gigs. Last time it indexed, it used only 3/4 of a gig. Some kind of indexing issue or something with Xcode. Did you get that, Hardboiled? Oh, you got it. You got it. All right. Nice. I got to get a drink of water real quick.
Be right back.
Xcode's still using a lot of memory. And it's using some compressed memory, whatever that means. Oh, world.bosses. Oh, man, I really do not want to change that type already. So let's do a boss status. Rocket Bunny, yeah, he's, the last time I saw him, he said something about how he has school earlier now, like he has school at something like 7 a.m. or some ungodly hour for school to be. Alright, so what's gonna happen if I use this? Oh, it doesn't even, I haven't even hooked up any of these methods yet. All right, so while I code these next methods, I guess I should set these to be all boss types. Do this right. Recompile everything again. Vector boss status. There, that's proper. Doing it proper, doing it right. Take this off. Okay, so now set boss status. This should be guaranteed to have the right array size, vector size for the bosses. So if it's the wrong Z, we're just return. Otherwise, world.bosses Z equals status. Next function, string world get bosses. It's gonna loop over all the areas, look for all the bosses and see. Wait. No, it just gets a string. Oh no, wait. Oh, it just loops over all the bosses. That's right. For auto ref. No ref. Auto status in world.bosses. We'll create a string stream. String stream. Putting out that status as an integer and then returning it. Okay, next method, void world set bosses const string ref. And we're just going to parse all these. So this is going to be vector of boss statuses. First, the vector of strings, though. So strings are, vector v split string. Here's where I would love to have some autocomplete working right now, but that's not gonna work. Freaking Mac compiling, trying to encode this stream. Look at it. Whoa, look at this. CPU is just slammed, totally maxed. Yeah, game show uses a hell of a lot more CPU now that I have to encode two different streams. It might be a problem for you guys watching, actually. This may be some cause of buffering. I might have to actually switch the stream up so it doesn't export a higher quality stream for YouTube. This certainly is a lot of CPU just going to running the stream. Okay, come on, split. Oh, thank God the split came up. Split that string by commas. Mac build. What's up, Gladiar? Okay, so looping over all the strings that we've just parsed from the bosses. It's gonna be, oh, this is gonna be integer. World dot bosses I equals boss status kit word is it get word word oh parse word all right so we're going to parse the word S. No. This is an integer. We need to parse no word. Parse int. S. Let's clamp that too. Clamp I. Parse in S between kboss unknown and kboss located. That's it. So we can get the bosses, set the bosses. Hey, what's up, PMC? Yeah, totally. Well, definitely an awesome trailer, right? Yeah, and several people have played The Witness. Lime Studios. I think Pedro's playing it. Yeah. Hardboiled played it. Oh no, Harbo didn't. Okay, let's see if this worked. So, Saul needs to get hooked up in game. So when it saves, needs to save the bosses. And when we load the game, it needs to load up all the bosses. Alright, let's see what happens. So, when I run this the first time and exit, it shouldn't have any bosses. Let's make sure this whole file is as I never put any bosses in here. Cool. I should be able to run this, exit out, and it shouldn't have put anything in there. Good. Okay, next test. Let's go save, and it should save all the zero bosses. So basically, it'll just be bosses 0000. There we go. Nice. We got 0000 for the bosses. Okay, let's hack the game a little bit. So I think I'm on, what level am I on? 4? So if we're on level 4, let's say we've found that boss. We gotta hook this up to the menu now. There's a function called reset boss pause that does that. Oh wait, let's do this. Let's just set that to 2 for a second. Run the game, save it again, and it should still have a 2. That would indicate that it parsed correctly and saved correctly. Looks like it. Okay. Now reset boss pause. This is different for the overworld. Because the overworld is going to be... Yeah, the overworld is going to be based on, like... Oh yeah, get interest pause is a Z from Z to Z. Yeah, get interest pause is going to be based on the... The first level you haven't completed, I guess. Yeah, so if you have the compass enabled for the overworld... It's just always going to work. Let's get it working in the dungeon first. All right, so this is dungeon. This is overworld. Only do the dungeon pause if world get boss status. For currency equals K boss located. Set the boss pause. Okay. Oh, this can totally just work this way. Show no boss pause if you've already located the boss for the Z. Otherwise, get the entrance pause for... So if the overworld has... Yeah, I basically just need to loop through all the dungeons and see which one you haven't defeated. So Z is 1, so we'll do this. Yeah, Z is 1. Z is less than K world num levels. Z plus plus. Z If that seemed right. If world get boss status for this Z is like we've already defeated this, so this is boss defeated. Or unknown, actually. Unknown or located, I guess. Either one of those. There's not defeated, yeah, not defeated. If you have not defeated this boss, it should show up. Yeah, that's right. That's right. Boss pause, world get entrance pause for this Z. Break. There. Okay, so we've got a method. So in dungeons, if you've used your compass, then it will show up until. Wait, this is wrong. I think this part's wrong here. Right, zealous, overly zealous heuristic algorithms. You just finished a heap vector class in C? Nice. Good job, KX. PMC, you played Songbringer or played the other game? Cyanger, what's up, man? Really? You thought there was another language between C and C++? That's funny. It does make sense, right? Okay, cool. All right. I think this is wrong. Get it. So we don't show the boss. Show the boss pause only if it's located, basically. There. Okay. Yeah, show the boss pause only if it's located on the overworld. We loop over. Let's just start at one. Every single one of the levels. World get boss status for that Z is not equal to defeated. Meaning it's either unknown or located, since that's what the overworld will point its compass towards. But that's only if the overworld itself has a status of located. All right. The next thing is when we defeat a boss, we need to set the boss status. And we also when we use the compass, we need to set the boss status. So an input system, when it uses a compass, it's going to launch the bio drone. No, we should immediately save this. Okay. So we've had that item, we're using the item. World set boss status to K boss located for the current Z. Cool. Yeah, so whenever we use a compass, no matter whether it's the overworld or a level, it sets the boss status for that to be located. Good. Now when we defeat a boss, health system, on foe death, if it's a boss and it's a level, flag this boss as defeated. World set boss status for or to be K boss defeated for this Z. We've defeated this boss now. And also we are always gonna set world. No. If world get or this, I'm gonna comment this. Always mark this boss defeated. Maybe use up the overworld's current compass. So if world get boss status for zero is K boss located. Technically, this should be, and this is the first. Nah. You might as well just use it up no matter which dungeon you're in. So if you've used your compass, now. Man, it really should check the actual dungeon. Okay. Where do we just do that? Create fire. No. Use map. No. Reset boss pause. Here we go. Okay, so this is where it looks for the first undefeated boss. So this needs to be a function in world as well. Get first boss. It's now static int get undefeated boss Z. First undefeated boss Z for the whole world. Compile that. World. Set bosses, get bosses, set boss status, int world, get boss, get first undefeated boss Z. Return Z. Return -1, indicating that that failed. Okay, and then back in can't even remember where it was. Here, reset boss pause. So, NZ equals world, get first undefeated boss Z. If Z is greater than or equal to 0, then we've got a boss to defeat. There. So now I can reuse this method in the other one I just wrote. Which was... Stop. I'm losing steam. I'm losing steam. I need lunch. Health system. That's right. Health system. Not this health system. Great, great, great. So, if we've defeated, if we had a map compass on the overworld, and it was the first undefeated boss Z that we're currently on, then world set boss status. K boss. Unknown. For Z0. There. That uses up the overworld's compass. All right, I think these methods are all in place so I can start testing this out. Good night, Happy Moose. Sorry, I miss you. One hour and a half already, huh? Right, you forgot about the stream. It is, right? It's cool. It definitely is cool. I love it. It's like, it's been this way for a whole, you know, for a whole, I don't know, 6 to 9 months or so. There's been a lot of you cool people on here chatting and sharing and giving each other points and tips and, like, playing each other's games. It's really cool. It's especially awesome for me at first because I was like, man, I finally have people that I interact with on a daily basis that know what the hell I'm doing. You know, like all my other friends in life basically have never really known what I do as a game developer. But we know what each other's do's, you know? We know what we do. We know what C++ is. We know how to make art, code, and all that kind of fun stuff. It's really neat to be part of that kind of, you know. And gamers, but I would imagine you're more than just the average person though, hard-boiled egg. Okay, so I'm gonna look over this to make sure it works and it should work, and then I'm gonna go and start testing out this and see if it works to, like, you know. Yeah, just testing it out. So, okay, so when we defeat an enemy, and this is a boss, and it's a level, then we always mark that boss as defeated, no matter what the boss's previous status was, totally independent of whether you picked up the heart, it marks it defeated. Okay, so this is now maybe use up the overworld's current compass. World, so if the boss status for the overworld is located, meaning that you've used the compass for it, and the world get first undefeated boss Z equals this Z, then we're gonna use up the overworld's boss status. There's one last thing that has to be in there. Make sure I did this. Yes, when you use a compass, it immediately locates that boss. Doesn't matter what Z, overworld or... Right, I think this is ready to try out. So how do I want to do this? I've already got the compass, or I've already located a boss for dungeon 4. So if I run this, we should have a boss indicator for dungeon 4. We knows what each other does. Yes! Where's Rocket Buddy when you need him? Yes. Right? Yeah, Saladongs. Alright, so do we have the compass? No? Is the right Z? What happened? We're at the Z4. This is 0, 1, 2, 3. Oh, it's 3. Okay. So now we should have located this boss. Good. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this again. Let's start. Let's put bosses. Oh, that's not gonna change it. Okay, let's set this all the way to 0. So we're starting off. We go to where the compasses and maps are. Here's some maps we've already used. Here's some maps we have yet to use. Here's some compasses we've already used. Here's some compasses we've yet to use. Okay, so what I'm going to do is use one of the compasses, and it should mark the boss as, right? Let's see what happens. So good, we have no boss shown. I got the scanner drones. Wait, no, I already used the scanner drones. I need the boss, the biodetector. Cool. I located the boss. Let's make sure that that's saved correctly. All the data is going to save nicely here. So we should have used up a compass. Yes, good. We've used up that compass. That's now a value of 1. The next thing we should have... Yep, there we go. It's located that boss. Good. So if I run this again... And I try and locate the boss again or whatever, it should not allow me to use the compass again. And then we'll go defeat the boss. Hard boil. Alright. So I try and use another one? Ooh, it's letting me. It shows 3 of them that I could use. Yeah, it totally did. Okay, that was mess up. Good thing I checked that. All right, so it already used that compass. It should only show 2 compasses. And it shouldn't allow me to use it. So, let's check this out. Gear component. It's like this thing where it counts your compasses. Count compasses. Check that first. 24-hour live chat room for developers. There's a thingy. What's it called? What are those things called? Slack or whatever? Slack, I think. There's a Slack forum thingy for that. It's not really like a chat as much as a forum, but it is kind of. It's almost chat. It's almost chat. It's the one that Zach Bell created, or their Stack Exchange. Which is less like a chat. What's this return? 3. Blah, blah, blah. Which three is it getting? Number six. Number seven. Hold on. We should have 10 compasses too, right? 0 through 9. 0 through 9, yeah. 6, 7, and 8. What? So 6 would be... Oh, look, there is no compass 8. What? What happened to compass 8? There's no compass 8! What happened to compass 8? Can I mess this up in the constants? This is a freaking awesome bug. Oh! Oh, Hardboiled, if you're still watching, this could totally explain why you used a scanner drone one time and it didn't work. Hopefully this is it. Oh, it is! Oh! Oh my god. Okay. There you go. That's compass 8 now. That fixes compass 8. So compass 8 was totally broken before. And that basically means that now, from now on, compass 8 will finally work. That's good. That was totally messed up, though, that, no, it was just counting compass 7 twice. Okay, yeah, no, that's expectable. Okay, so now we should only have 2 compasses. Yeah, dude, I love all this giving. Yeah, there it is, Sackbella Game Slack. Platformer Labs, do you have a rough idea about how much you're going to charge for a Steam key? Yes, I do. For the fight, you're talking about the final version of the game. The final version of the game is going to be $16. There's going to be a high quality version, or not a high quality version, but more of like a premium version, which includes the original soundtrack. That one will be $20. And that's it. Yeah, it's just 16 or 20. Yo, what's up, Steve Tramby? Good, that time I returned to... Okay, let me delete this breakpoint. That's really great to have that fixed. So now, it's already located this boss, so I should not be able to even equip the biodetector. Oh, it's allowing me to equip it still. Okay, so that needs to be fixed. So, can equip. Oh, because I haven't written the function for it. So this is return. Oh, we need a can use compass function. This will make this more organized. Okay. Last method to add to world today, and then I'll be ready to check this in, I think. Get, what is it? Can use. How come I can't see where that is? Static bool can use compass int quantity, compile that, spend the next 5 minutes compiling, huh? That sounds fun. Yeah. Woo. Final version? Okay, cool. Glad we're on the same page there. Yep. Final version of the game will be $16. Not exactly sure exactly when that's going to be, but beta is definitely going to be February 21st. What are your goals in life? Me, make a game, finish Songbringer in 1 hour. Oh, become a mod on the Wizard Food streams. Finish Songbringer in 1 hour. That's going to be crazy. I'm really excited to when the game it gets totally complete and you got all these dungeons and everything, and then there's like cool secrets, and maybe I would like to have some like warp points, like somehow you can warp from certain parts of the world to others so you can really speed run fast if you know what to do. Yeah, so we can only use compasses on a level or the overworld. If it's not the level and it's not the overworld, then return false. And this is, you can use the compass only if boss is not already located. So if world get boss status for this Z oh, this is basically only if boss is unknown, because you can use a compass if it's unknown, or, yeah, no, only if it's unknown, because you don't want to use your compass if you've already located the boss or if you've already defeated the boss. All right, so boss is not equal to unknown, then return false. There, now we got a convenient method we can call from anywhere to see if we can use a compass. Need more achievable goals. Kickstarter, one of the only places to get a small loan of $1 million. True. Donation. Pledge. It's almost not even a donation. It's not really a donation because people get rewards for it. You know, it's almost like they're pre-purchased. It's like you get... Kickstarter is basically the best way to get pre-orders for your game ever. That's basically what it boils down to. You're getting pre-orders. People are buying something from you in advance. Yes, there's the chance that you might fail to even create it, and then those people are going to be, you know, out of luck, and they basically spent money, and their pre-order is going to be worth nothing. But you need to be a mod just to not get banned. Don't worry, Hardboiled, you'll get there, man. You'll get there. At some point, we'll have to concede and make you a mod. And then there'll be a mod war, I'm sure. Investment. It's kind of an investment website, but really more so is the Sprout one or the Sprig or whatever that Fig one is. But yeah, Fig is, I think, what's it called? It's Fig, right? Fig. Fig. Yeah, fig.co. Fig is a curated platform for crowdfunding, investing in games, but it's also, especially it's investing. But it looks like they only had, I think so far they really have only done like Double Fine. Look at that, they raised 4 million. Outer Wilds, is that it? There's not any other games? There's only two games. I don't know what this is. Yeah, I guess it's different because they really allow investment in the actual games. You can literally invest in a game this way. Yeah, treating it like it's a donation definitely is a good attitude, because then you don't worry if you do get the reward. Yeah. All right, Platformer Lab, see you, man. How much more do I need to pay to get a life-size rock cardboard cutout? You got a David Hasselhoff one? Awesome. Oh, that should be a thing, huh? The more fine print you read, yeah, and the fact that they only have two games on there. There's got to be something wrong with that. This is world can use compass quantity. Quantity, come on, autocomplete, seriously. All right, and then in input system, one last thing check is if we can use it. There. So now it'll make an invalid noise if we try and use a compass that we can't use. How long has the stream got? Probably only like 5 more minutes or so. I gotta get some dinner, and this is almost done. You don't actually have a hassle cut out. Mustache jib would be sweet. You cry at night. Alright, so we've already located the boss. We should not even be able to equip this now. Yes. I can't equip any maps either because I've already totally explored all this dungeon with maps. Awesome. So next check, let's go defeat this boss. Okay, I'm not even gonna take the life. I'm just gonna save it now, and it should have marked this boss as defeated. So, yes, it used up my compass before. No, it didn't mark the boss as defeated. Oh, because this boss doesn't have the big ol' explosion. Oh, that's easy to fix. Health system. Whenever we kill a foe, and the current area has the flag. Yeah, alright, so if area dot flags and K flag boss, and we've completed this area, area dot get completion factor equals 1 and is level. Oh shit, this should be in the. There's a better way to do this. There's a collision. Is it collision system? It's like a bad place for this, actually. It seems like a bad. It's not intuitive. See, check completion. Collision system, check completion. It automatically locks doors, activates incomplete, activates complete. Yeah, this is right where it belongs. Flag this boss is defeated. If it's a area.getFlags. Flags boss. This completion factor is all done. And we're in a level. Yeah, this should be right. Okay. Alright, let's see what happens this time. My character is now going to be a David Hasselhoff's living head in a jar. Yeah! Oh, you got the elemental sword still? Oh my god. That was intense. Okay, there. Oh yes, it unlocked the door, so it should have called that code. Now we have bosses 1! Yeah! It marked that boss as defeated. But now it's not gonna, it's like it's gonna recapitulate the right, if I run this again, it'll still have the boss. So we need to start using this new boss thing to see if it's defeated already. Yeah. I think that's an area. When it creates the area, create foes. Yeah, remove boss if already obtained the item. Let's make this remove boss if it's already defeated. If it's alive, it's a level. Aim. All right, this needs to be two branches of logic here now. All right. Remove boss or switch. If flags and K flag boss. Else if flags and K flag switch and player.gear.count. Oh, getting low on battery life over here. What secret project you guys working on? Sweet. Ah, why does it keep playing?
What's up, Pedro? Space my name.
Count player.gear.count area items 0. Yeah, so if it already has a switch, erase the foe. Or we, if it's the flag boss and we've already defeated this boss, we'll get boss status for area pause.z equals k boss defeated. We've already defeated this boss. Remove it. Or flags and switch and counts greater than 0. Okay, there's one last thing I should check. In world, I always say one last, right? One last thing, one more thing. There's only one more thing. What is that? Like, am I a donkey and that's my carrot? Gibbs, there's something like, is boss defeated? Is dungeon complete? There it is. This is an old ass function we should probably take out. Is dungeon complete? So, no longer need this. Let's start compiling it already. Now we just got boss status. All right, this is the last time I'm recompiling today, because that's like another 5 minutes or whatever. If we visited the destination And it's not complete, which means get boss status for C. It's not equal to K boss defeated. There, so map locations for bosses you have not completed. Any dungeon where you that has a boss that has not been completed will be white on the map. Okay. Ugh. Must make it to end of stream. It was a pretty long stream, right? Is it? How long is it? Oh, it's already 2 hours. Yep. So that's it. I'm just gonna run this like you know one more time. Oh, a couple more times. Couple more times. 5 minutes. 5 minutes. I'll give 5 more minutes just to test out these maps a little bit more, or compasses, and then yeah. So hopefully by tonight I'll have an upload ready for Steam. If not, I might do it tomorrow. But I would like once again, I like to reiterate, I'm going to start getting in the habit of doing an update to Steam like once a week. I'm thinking like Fridays or Saturdays maybe. That's like a good day to always update to Steam. So you guys can kind of expect to have something each week to play that's new. And, you know, I think I can maintain that throughout the alpha period and the beta period. We'll see. That's just going to be a hell of a lot of updating. But I think now that I have a master branch and a fun branch, this is totally doable. I should delete my HUD branch or whatever the heck that is. You still know what Wizard's working on. Right? No one can complete dungeons anymore. There we go. Alright, so I've already defeated the bosses for this boss. So it didn't recreate the foes now. Should be the same for switches. Switches to still be able to. Okay, so if I save this now, it should still have the switches working. Switch to 4 is enabled. So if I run this again, it should have no enemies on the screen. Did you get royalties? What? Oh. Yeah, scrap Songbringer. The game shows you a picture of an egg, you have to guess it. If it's hard boiled. That's awesome. In which days there's no stream? Just so I'll be able to get to go to sleep at a normal time? It's a good question. Very good question, Hardwell. That changes every week. Oh, I'm sorry about that. I don't mean to keep you up too late, man. Oh, and now that I've defeated the boss, there shouldn't be any Yeah, good. Alright, I think I'm going to call it there for the end of this stream. So what I'm going to work on next, though, is I'm going to go test this some more for the overworld. So, like, I'll use the scanner drones on the overworld. It should locate the nearest, level that I haven't defeated or whatever. And then once I defeat that boss, it should no longer mark it as still, you know, available or whatever. So, yeah. That's what I'm going to work on next. So that's it for today's stream, you guys. Have a good one. BC Warrior. Yeah, thanks for joining, you guys. Appreciate y'all. Have a great night.